this video we are going to discuss about 12th standard computer science chapter 6 control structures. So last class we discussed about what are the different types of looping statements used in Python programming language. Okay, now in this class we are going to discuss about jump statements in Python programming language. Okay, so what does mean by jump? Jump means we are transferring the control from one place to another place. Okay, so jump statements are used to transfer the control from one place to another place without checking the condition. That is known as jump statements. Okay, now you can see the definition. The jump statement in Python is used to unconditionally transfer the control from one part of the program to another. Okay, without checking the condition, you can transfer the control from one place to another place is known as a jump statement. There are three types of jump statements used in Python programming language. That is break, continue, pass. Okay, so these three are keywords. Okay, so there are three keywords to achieve jump statements in Python programming language. The three jump keywords are break, continue, pass. The following flowchart illustrates the use of break and continue statements. How break and continue statements used to move the control from one place to another place. Okay, now you can see this flowchart. It first check the condition. Maybe consider this is on loop statements. Okay, so we just check the condition. When the condition is true, some set of statements can be repeated. Okay, so in this when the condition is true, it executes the statement 1. Okay, and then in this statement block 1, we are having break statement also. Okay, so when the condition is when the control reaches this break statement, automatically the control transfer to the loop. Again it exit from the loop. Okay, so once the break statement is reached, it exit from the loop. See this arrow mark, it is used to show it is exit from the loop and goes to the further statements of the program. Otherwise, when the break statement is not executed, then it goes to the continue. Without executing the statement, and again it continued the next iteration. Okay, so break and continue statement is used to transfer the control. Break is used to exit from the current loop. Okay, so when the control reaches to break statement, it exits from the current loop. If for example on that loop we are specifying 10 times you want to repeat, okay, but in between you have to check the condition. The value of I is equal to 100. So when the value of I is reached 100 means we just exit from the loop. Without reaching to the last value, you specify the condition whether the value of I is 100, then it exit from the loop. If you want to terminate the loop before the number of times, before the specified number of times, then we can use a break statement. Break statement is used to exit from the current loop. Okay, so when the control reaches the break statement, it automatically exit this repetition and goes to the other statements used in that program. Okay, otherwise the control is not reached the break statement, the control reached to the continue statement, then it force the next iteration to take place. Okay, the stay after this continue statements is not executed, it automatically again goes to the loop statement and increment the value of I and execute the next statement. That is, continue statement force the next iteration of the loop statement. Okay, so this two statement is not reached, then it goes to the statement n and again goes to the condition and check the values. When the condition is true, the statements can be repeated. Otherwise, when the condition is false, it exit from this repetitions and goes to the else block. Okay, that is statement 1, statement 2, statement n will be executed. Okay, after this else block, it goes to the further statements of the program. You can see when the control reaches this break statement, it not goes to the else block. It directly goes out of this for loop. Okay, after the else statement, what are the statements is present, that statement can be executed. Okay, for that only you have to specify break statement is used to exit from the current loop. Thus, loop statements can be exit, okay, exit, exit, and it move on to the next set of statements. Okay, so now you can see the definitions about break statement. The break statement terminates the loop containing it. Okay, so why we need a break statement? Break statement is used to terminate the loop statement. Control of the program flows to the statement immediately after the body of the loop. So the control flow, it move on to the after the body of the loop. Okay, a while or for loop will iterate till the condition is tested false. So normally how the while and for loops are executed, the set of statements can be repeated till the test condition is false. Okay, but one can even transfer the control out of the loop with help of break statements. So if you want to terminate the loop before to reach the end of the number of times, then we can use a break statement. Okay, so when the break statement is executed, the control flow of the program comes out of the loop and starts executing the segment of code after the loop structure. Okay, if break statement is inside a nested loop, break will terminate the innermost loop. So if you want to use nested loops, so nested, what is meant by nested loops? A loop within a loop is known as a nested loop. We see some examples of nested loop also. Okay, so nested loop means a loop placed within another loop. We already discussed in 11th standard, no, what is the meaning of nested loop. Now also we see some examples of nested loops. Nested loop means a loop within another loop is known as a nested loop. So one can place a while within another while loop, for within another for, or for within while, and while within for loop. We can nest any for either the same loops, that is while or for, or we can also nest with the while loop with the for loop, or for loop with the while loop. Okay, all this nesting is possible in Python programming language. Now you can see the example how to print this number pattern 1 1 2 1 2 3 1 2 3 4 and then 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, so now you can see the example program I equal to 1. So we take the control variable I equal to 1 while I less than or equal to 6. Okay, so check the condition whether the value of I is less than or equal to 6. And then we are using the for loop for j in range of 1, i. So the range function, we already discussed, you know, why we need a range function. Range function is used to create a list of values. Okay, so print j comma end equal to slash t. So what purpose we are using the slash t? Slash t is used to leave a tab space. And then print end equal to slash n. Slash n is used to move the cursor to the next line. Okay, it moves on the next line. Slash n is used to move to the next line. And then we increment the value of I by 1. I equal to I plus 1. Okay, I equal to, either we can write I plus equal to 1, or we can also rewrite I equal to I plus 1. Okay, so in short form we can write I plus equal to 1. So we can also expand this statement I equal to I plus 1. So now you can see how this program code can be executed. It first check the condition. What is the value for I? I value is 1. 1 less than or equal to 6. The condition is true. So when the condition is true, it moves on the body of the while loop. Okay, so which one is the first statement in body of the while loop? For j in range of 1, i. Now the value of i is 1. Okay, so 1 is equal to 1, condition is true. Now it goes to the print statement, print j comma end equal to slash t. So it print the value. What is the value stored in j? 1. So it store print display the output 1. Again the control transfer to the for loop and check the condition. Again the control transfer to the for loop and check the condition. It increment the value of j by 1. There is no step value is given, no. If the step value is not given, it increment by default, it increment the value of j by 1. So the value of j is 2. 2 less than or equal to 1. The condition is false. So once the condition is false, the innermost loop is not executed. Again it goes to the while loop. Now the value of for loop is false. It exit the loop and go to the statement print. Print end equal to slash n. Now the cursor moves to the next line. Okay. And then it increment the value of I by 1. So I equal to I plus 1. That is 1 plus 1. And the value of I is 2. Again it goes to the while loop. And check the condition 2 less than or equal to 6. The condition is true. So once the condition is true, it goes to the for loop. For j in range of 1 comma I. For each time when the control enter into the loop. And the first time enter into the loop, it takes the initial value. Now the value of j is 1 and then end value I value is 2. Okay, so it goes, it print the value, print j comma end. So it print the value 1, again the repetition, it print the next value 2. Okay, here we can see the while loop is used here. One more loop, that is for loop. While is nested with the for loop. Okay. So this loops can be repeated again and again. We get the answer like this. We get the number pattern. Okay. So once the J loop is false, it goes to the print statement end equal to slash n. For that only we are getting the next row. Okay. Here we can see the space between 1 and 2, the numbers. Okay. 1, 2, 3. One tab space is given. No, how you can get this tab space? See, in this print statement, j comma end equal to slash t. So from the statements we can get the tab space between the numbers. Okay, and then the value of I is incremented in the last statement of this program, I plus equal to 1. So when the while statement reads, the value of I is 7 less than or equal to 6. The condition is false, the program execution can be stopped. It show the output like this. Okay, so this is the nested loop. When we use break statement inside of this inner loop. Okay, so if you are using break statement in this for loop, then it exit from this inner loop alone. The control transfer to the outer loop. Okay, that is given in this statement. Okay, so when the break statement is executed, the control flow of the program comes out of the loop and starts executing the segment of code after the loop structure. If break is inside a nested loop, break will terminate the innermost loop. Okay, so break will terminate only the innermost loop, not the whole loop. Okay, is it clear, ma? Okay, now you can see the next, that is next syntax of break statement. Okay, so what is the syntax? We just write a keyword break alone. Okay, we write a keyword break and then see the flow chart of break statement. So once it enter into the loop, it check the condition. When the condition is true, it goes to the remaining, that is body of the loop can be repeated. Maybe when you are using break statement in this loop, it check the break statement. If it is reached, then it exit from the loop. Otherwise, continue the remaining body of the loop. Repetitions can be continued. So when the condition is false, it exit from the loop. Okay. So when the control reaches the break statement, it automatically exit from the loop. Okay. Otherwise, it continue the statements again. Now you can see the example for working of break statement in for loop and while loop. Okay, for var in sequence, here the counter variable we are using var. Okay, if condition, when this condition is satisfied, it goes to the control transfer to the break statement. So it exit from the loop. Okay, code inside for loop, code outside for loop, it exit from the loop. While test expression, code inside the while loop. Okay, if condition, it check the condition. When the control reaches this break statement, it automatically exit from the while loop. Okay, so when the control reaches the break statement, it automatically exit from the current loop. That's all. Okay, now you can understand what is the meaning of break statement. When the control reaches the break statement, it automatically exit from the current loop. So now you can see one example. This example we are going to print the letter. Okay, so program to illustrate the use of break statement inside the for loop. For word in jump statement, here the counter variable is word and then the sequence of statements here given, the sequence it's given one string value, that is jump statement. Okay, so for each iteration it takes the character one by one. For word in jump statement, if word equal to e, check the condition whether the word reached the character E. So when this condition is true, then the control goes to the break statement. Okay, otherwise it print a word and leave one space. Okay, so say this first, what is the word it takes, what is the letter it takes? J equal to E. Condition is false. So once the condition is false, it directly goes to the print statement. So it print the character J, and then again the control transfer to the for loop, and it takes the second letter. What is the second letter? U. So U, and then check the condition. Next statement, it check the condition. U equal to E. It is not equal, then it goes to the print. Okay, so here we are using the simple if statement. Simple if statements is having only the true block. In this true block, what is the statement is given? It given only break statement. Okay, the control again transfer to the print statement. It print the letter U, and then again it goes to the for loop. I take the second, third letter, that is M. So again it checks M equal to E. The condition is false, so it print the letter M. Okay, here not leaving space. Here the jump M will be printed. Again it goes to the for loop and take the next letter P. Again it checks P equal to E. Condition is false. So it execute the print statement and print the letter P. Okay, and then leave one space. And then again it takes the next letter S next letter is empty space. It check empty space equal to E. This is also false. Okay, so when the condition is false, it goes to the print statement and leave space. Okay, again it takes the statement letter S equal to E. So this process can be continued until the letter E is reached. Okay, STAT will be printed. It takes the letter E. It check the condition E equal to E. The condition is true. So once the condition is true, the break statement can be executed. So break, once the control reaches to the break statement, it exits from the loop. We are having the remaining letters, that is E, M, E, N, T. Remaining 5 more letters is there, 5 more execution is there. But the control exits from this loop because of this break statement. For this purpose only, we are using the break statement. Okay. So, break statement is used to terminate the loop statements unconditionally. Okay. So, for that only, we are using the break statement. Okay. That's all about this break statement. In the next class, we discuss about continue and pass statements. Okay, students, thank you.